Hello everyone, we are going to see the principle of flotation and the expression for the floating body. So see here carefully, we are knowing that when a body immersed in liquid, two forces act. Number one, weight of body surely will act. Weight of body W1 acting downward. Right? And we are knowing that according to the Archimedes principle, when a body is immersed in a liquid, upward force act. Word force. This upward force is called upthrust. Let upthrust denoted by W2, it is acting upward on the body. And we are knowing that this upthrust is equal to upthrust is equal to weight of displaced liquid. And it is by Archimedes' principle, we know. Now see how these three forces are responsible for a floating body. To understand the fundamental in detail, see this diagram carefully. It is here in the container, liquid is filled and we are immersing a body, right? The three conditions are there of immersion. When we see two forces acting on it, the weight always acting downward and upthrust acting W2 upward. In the diagram. Now three cases arises. These three cases we will understand here in the three different diagram A, B and C. Right? So for the first A, it is discussed earlier, when body is immersed in a liquid, two forces act, W1, weight of body acting downward and upthrust acting upward on the body. The in three cases, the first case is if W1 is greater than W2. This is the first case here in this W1 is greater than W2. That is weight of body. Equal to greater than weight of upthrust or weight of the displaced liquid, right? If this is possibility, in that condition it is observed that body sinks in the liquid. Second case is case number B, when W1 is equal to W2. Right? So experimentally it is observed that when weight of body is equal to the thrust acting on a body, in that condition body float just like a diagram, just below the surface of a liquid. Below the surface of liquid. Here in the diagram, see carefully. Right? Now see the case number C here in the diagram. What is happening in the C? C is a case when W1 weight of body is less than, right? W1 and W2. Is W1 is less than that, that is weight of body is less than up thrust. Then experimental observation shows that body float. Float partially. Partially means here the mean upward partially in the sense some portion seat is inside the fluid and some portion outside. Right? This is the experimental observations. What happened? The floating of a system is under two conditions. See in the box. Partially floating is under one case. See in this black box. Float, float. Just below the surface. So no portion will be seen outside. But this floating is some portion inside and some portion outside. Clear? Then how? So we will focus only on here three. How much portion will be inside and how will portion outside when it is floating under a condition when W1 is less than W2. So see very carefully here in the diagram. If body is floating under case C when W1 is less than W2 in this case. See very clear. So how much portion will be sink and will be inside the fluid and how much portion outside? It can be obtained when we will understand the fact here. The fact here, when body floats, float in which condition? Under condition C. This implies that body adjusted in such a way. It adjusted in such a way that we are knowing. So how much is adjusted? See very carefully. To understand this, see the W2 force acting on a body. That is the thrust. And this thrust is equal to the weight of a displaced liquid. If weight of a displacement liquid is more, up thrust will act more. But here in case of floating, it is adjusted in such a way, these two figures, up thrust adjusted in such a way that this up thrust acting on a body, this weight of a body, force one, weight of body, this is W1, see in this case, is equal to weight of the displaced liquid. In weight of displaced liquid. See here, if both are exactly equal, just below the surface of liquid. W1 is greater than W2, sink. But if it is less, so if portion come in such a way that W1 and this W2 up thrust, that is weight of displaced liquid, becomes equal. Otherwise up thrust is more, weight is less here. So it float. So condition reach when both becomes equal. Right? This statement is called principle of superposition. Principle of flotation. This is statement. What is the principle of flotation? Gibbs, weight of when a body float in the liquid, its weight adjusted in such a way that it become equal to the thrust or weight of the displaced liquid acting on it. So this is the principle of flotation and their statement. So statement can be written as in this way. Now one more thing. We are going to see the expression in this regard, in which mathematical expression under which the body float. Right? So see the weight of a body we are going to see. First factor. Weight of body. Weight of body means weight is mass into gravity. Mass means volume into density into g, where symbols have their meanings. Capital V is equal to volume of body, floating body. D is density of body, and g is acceleration due to gravity, we will know, right? And we are going to see the weight of displaced liquid. Weight of displaced liquid. Weight means mg. M is mass, volume into density. So see, volume of displaced liquid means small v. Small v denotes volume of displaced liquid. Into density in place of this density of liquid, dl, density of liquid. See carefully. Into acceleration due to gravity. See these two factors carefully. In principle of flotation, these two things are equal. So we have calculated weight of body expression as equation number 1, and weight of displaced liquid as equation number 2. But in reference of principle of flotation, both are equal. So we may write, according to principle of flotation, weight of, what is the principle of flotation? Weight of body is equal to weight of liquid displaced. So weight of body is here what? V d z is equal to small v dl g, right? G is cancelled by g. And now by rearranging, small v by capital V is equal to d by dl. This is called condition of flotation. See, condition of flotation. Right? Small v by capital V, it is the ratio of which small v is volume of smallest part. R is equal to volume of displaced liquid, mean volume of immersed part. So it is V by V here, means see here, small V by capital V is, it is the ratio of immersed part, and it is equal to D by DL. This is density of solid to density of liquid. So how much portion will be sink? It will depend upon the ratio of their density. That is why this expression is called condition of flotation. So, and principle of flotation is this much only. When body floats, body adjusted in such a way that weight of body becomes equal to weight of displaced liquid. That is called principle of flotation. So this is for the topic only. Thank you and have a nice day to all.